Hurricanes are huge low-pressure areas. They are called typhoons or tropical cyclones in other parts of the world. But how do they actually arise? In the summer months, the intertropical convergence zone is located north of the equator. West of the coast of North Africa, where most Atlantic hurricanes originate, there is a low-pressure area that causes precipitation. If the low-pressure area moves to warmer areas where the water is at least 26.5 degrees Celsius, such as the Caribbean, the air pressure can become even lower. Above this warm water, the air is heated and will rise. Higher in the atmosphere, water vapor condenses and the heat needed to evaporate the water is released again. This heat is called latent heat. The air continues to rise due to the released latent heat. High in the atmosphere, there are now many air particles, more than in the environment. The air particles will spread so that there are fewer air particles in the lower pressure area, and the air pressure therefore decreases further. As a result, more air is drawn in, which will rotate around the low pressure area due to the Coriolis effect. In the northern hemisphere, the air rotates counterclockwise and rises. Because the air turns inward, it will move faster and faster. The wind speed increases. When the wind speed is up to 62 km per hour, it is called a tropical depression. Wind speeds of 63 to 118 km per hour are called a tropical storm. When the wind speed exceeds 119 km per hour, it's called a hurricane. There are several lines with rain, so-called rain bands. The closer the wind gets to the center, the faster the wind blows. Then the rising air arrives at the core of the hurricane. This is called the eye and is about 45 kilometers in diameter on average. The wind descends here and there is hardly any wind on the surface. When the air descends, the air gets warmer so that in the eye there is not only little wind, it also doesn't rain. Some people think when they are in the eye of the hurricane that the storm is over. This is therefore very dangerous because the storm quickly continues again. The most dangerous part of the storm is the eye wall. This is the rain band around the eye where the wind is strongest and the most precipitation falls. Once the rising air is higher in the atmosphere, it moves back out to the right, similar to the movement of a high pressure area. As the hurricane moves to other areas, the hurricane may decrease in strength. As the hurricane moves to colder seas, the hurricane lacks the energy it needs. Even a shallower sea can ensure that colder seawater is drawn to the surface, causing the hurricane to cease to exist. Even when the hurricane comes ashore, it lacks the humid warm air that acted as an energy source and the wind speed decreases, making it a tropical storm and ultimately a tropical depression. Most victims fall when the hurricane comes ashore. Especially the right side of the hurricane in the northern hemisphere pushes up the seawater. This is the part of the hurricane where the wind speed is combined with the speed of advancing the entire hurricane. Waves can reach a height of 7 meters and floods can occur. In addition, the low pressure area sucks up the seawater, causing it to rise. This is called a storm surge. Flooding often occurs together with a lot of precipitation and rivers that are no longer able to drain their water due to the higher sea level. If this coincides with spring tide, the consequences can even be more serious. Because a lot of heat is needed to form a hurricane, it often starts in the tropical zone, around the intertropical convergence zone. Hurricanes do not originate exactly on the equator because the Coriolis effect is absent here. The hurricane season begins on June 1st in the northern hemisphere, but especially at late summer, when the seawater has warmed, most hurricanes occur. They then move in a westerly and northwesterly direction. Hurricanes are given male and female names before the hurricane season begins. The first storm of the year is given a name that begins with an A, the second a name that begins with a B, and so on. Names of very devastating hurricanes will not be used for several years. To distinguish between the strength of hurricanes, a classification based on wind speed is used. At wind speeds of 119 till 154 km per hour, it is called a class 1 hurricane. At wind speeds of 155 till 178 km per hour, it is called a class 2 hurricane. At wind speeds of 179 till 210 km per hour, it is called a class 3 hurricane. At wind speeds of 211 till 250 km per hour, it is called a class 4 hurricane. At wind speeds of more than 250 km per hour, it is called a class 5 hurricane. So, hurricanes form in late summer in tropical regions, moving westward and gaining strength over warmer seawater.